Rewind to 1900, and picture this. Gasoline is on fire at hundreds of oil refineries across the world. Every hour, countless gallons of fuel are being wasted. Countless tons of CO2 emitted. But this is no freak catastrophe. This is by design. In the early 20th century, oil refineries had a simple primary goal: turn crude oil into kerosene, which, before electricity, was in demand for heating and lighting. Gasoline was simply a useless byproduct and was burned away. Noticing this, automotive pioneers like Benz, who designed one of the first car engines, and Ford, who produced the first cars at scale, saw an opportunity, using this unwanted gasoline as car fuel. Today, things have flipped. Gasoline gets all the love. Nearly 50% of crude oil becomes gasoline. And kerosene, the former star, has fallen way out of favor. Less than 1% of crude oil now becomes kerosene. But gasoline isn't the only relative newcomer. Today, there are more different uses for oil and gas-derived products than there've ever been. Jet fuels, propane, synthetic clothes, plastics, asphalt, the list of end products goes on and on. The one big thing, well, very tiny thing, these products have in common is carbon, and in particular, hydrocarbon molecules. Hydrocarbons contain both hydrogen and carbon atoms and can come in thousands of different sizes and configurations, like methane, which contains only one carbon, ethane, which has two, propane, which has three, and so on. Hydrocarbons have a number of useful products. They're like the Swiss Army knives of nature. What can't you do with them? For one, they store a lot of energy, and that makes them great fuels. Plus, they can be pulled apart and mixed and matched to create substances with distinct properties, as needed for any number of materials. Say, lightweight rigidity, useful in plastics, or elasticity, useful in fabrics. Making, moving, and selling these end products is the work of two critical stages of the oil and gas value chain: midstream, which moves and stores hydrocarbons, and downstream, which makes usable products and sells them. Upstream, the piece of the puzzle we're not focused on in this primer, produces, aka extracts from the ground, two distinct types of raw hydrocarbon mixtures. Crude oil, a complex, liquid mixture of larger hydrocarbon molecules, and raw natural gas, a simpler, gaseous mixture of smaller hydrocarbon molecules. Crude oil and raw natural gas then follow separate, though largely parallel, paths through the mid and downstream, ultimately reaching the market in the form of any number of oil-derived or gas-derived end products. Many of downstream's end products go on to separate industries, like chemicals and pharmaceuticals, before becoming finished products. These sectors are beyond this primer's scope. In this primer, we'll look under the hood of mid and downstream, covering the end products, the raw sources, transportation and storage, refining and processing, the economics, and the players in the ecosystem.